thanks so much for stopping by. I have another layout share video for you. So I have been scrapbooking quite a bit. I actually was at a scrapbook retreat a couple weeks ago at the beginning of the month, which was super fun. I didn't get a whole lot done, but I did get some scrapbooking in, and that was fine with me. I think I got 7 layouts done at that retreat, and it was about an 8-hour retreat. And I did take a break for lunch, and I did talk a lot and just hang out, but it was fun. So I'm going to share with you the layouts that I've done for this month, and then I'm going to put them away because I'm ready to put them into my albums. All right, so let's get started. This first one here is a double pager, and I actually need to add journaling to this still. So I'm going to actually do that as soon as I finish with the video. This is my son, and this is a double pager, and I'm so sorry about the glare, but it's very cloudy out today, and I figured I would have my light on because I didn't want the video to be so dark. But anyways, back to the layout. This is a double pager. I did do a little mixed media, which I don't do that often. Just some multi-surface white paint across here. These are all hearts that you can either hand cut, you can punch them, whatever. And then I did do some of them. I did double hearts, and then I just outlined everything. I have some cute little sayings mixed in there. You could use this for Valentine's Day or whatever, but I didn't want to use it for Valentine's Day. So these are just some really fun, cute pictures of my son kind of posing. This was a choir concert that he was getting ready to go to. And so I just thought it was really, really cute. I did sew the rickrack onto my layout here with some black thread, and then I just put the hearts over top. I didn't sew the hearts though. And I'm gonna do some strips of white printout journaling here, and then this one will be done, just explaining what this event was for him. All right, the next one I did at the crop, and this is just really, really old pictures of my daughter. This is back from 2010. She was into skateboarding at the time, and so I just wanted to document that. And these papers and these embellishments, these were like punch out embellishments from like a 12 by 12 sheet. This little skateboard here is actually Kiwi Lane. So cute. I just thought I would cut it out and put it on the page. It went perfect. But yeah, using up some really old product. I want to think this might have been SEI product, but don't quote me on that. Right, this one I also did at the retreat, and I used a paper collection called, let's see, this paper collection here. It is called Summer Fun, and this is what I have left, just a few of the cutouts and some scraps, but I did use quite a bit of that up, and this is one of the layouts that I did of my daughter. Used a bunch of Kiwi Lane templates. I took some with me, did some layering of embellishments. I actually cut that out of the card, and there's some puffy stickers on here and just some miscellaneous embellishments from my stash. And then this one is also from the same collection, and more Kiwi Lane templates up there and down here. And this is actually the sample sheet that you get in the front cover of the collection, so why not use it, right? It's so cute. So another one of my daughter splashing in the pool, looking at her phone. Another puffy, this is a puffy. Yeah, super cute. I love how those turned out. And then I made this one at the retreat as well, and it's the same paper collection. I love to use up a paper collection. This is my son hanging in the pool as well. So a lot of pool pictures that I needed to get done. And this one is also from that collection, and this is my same son. He was having a blast cleaning the pool, so I got him in all kind of stages here. That was fun. And this I just used strips of paper, super cut strips of paper, different sizes. Really, really easy. Added in some of the stickers from the sheets and some of these cards. Super easy. And then I think this might have been the last one I used from that collection. And this is a picture of my daughter and I by the pool we had at the house we were staying at. just some miscellaneous, you guys. Same paper collection, but a whole bunch of different embellishments from my stash. And then the stickers, this is from the sticker sheet, this little banner down here. Okay, and then the next one I made, this is the one that took me forever at the scrapbook retreat, and that's why I only got like 7 layouts done, because this one I did a lot of hand stitching on, and everybody thought I was crazy. I actually did win first place out of, I don't know, hundreds of ladies, but not that many enter the contest, obviously, but I did win first place. So it's, this is the hand stitching that I did. All between the hearts is hand stitched, and then this giant heart is all hand stitched on my layout. This is all I got done and entered, just a single pager with one photo on it. It's actually a double pager. It goes like this. But I was in the middle of just finishing that one up when I needed to enter it into the contest, and so I didn't get a chance to get this one put together. I had finished almost this, I think I hadn't even started actually on this one. So I did end up finishing it, gluing all the hearts on. I think I ended up finishing it there, but I couldn't enter it in. But yeah, no big deal. But this one is just all little baby hearts all cut out. Same heart, just the opposite of, so you can see the big side of the hearts on the opposite sides. And then I just did some, I'm really into buttons again. So I've been adding them on a lot of things lately. Some little flowers. This is when my husband and I were in Puerto Vallarta. And yeah, I just thought that turned out really cute, but that did take me a really long time to do. I like the hanging hearts. I just thought that was a fun feature. And then this is from, this is kind of off the same photos from that trip. And same using hearts again. But this time I decided to do some mixed media. So this heart, I traced it on around this side, and then I actually used my sewing machine since I was at home, and I actually sewed this heart. And then I did some mixed media with white paint, like I did on my son's layout. And then I just added all the embellishments on top of that. And then on this side, it's the same. This one is actually a cardstock heart. And then this one, I actually, after I put this one down and I traced one over here, and then I sewed and put the mixed media on that side. So you can see here's buttons and hearts. So that's the double pager. And these are all pictures from Puerto Vallarta that go with the other heart layout. Okay, oh, we're back to this one I actually made at the retreat, and I made that with the summer fun paper as well, and it's just more pictures from Cabo. And this is just another one of my daughter, but just really simple and easy. This is just the back side of this sheet here, and I just cut a square and then flipped it and then put it back in. Added a bunch of really old embellishments. This is like a Dear Lizzie little stick pin thing that has like a glittery heart on it. Just added some twine to it. All right, I think that's all from the retreat, but we'll see. And then I made a two-pager with a pocket page, and it actually goes like this. This might have more of a glare on it because it isn't a pocket page, but I used KiwiLean templates down the middle here. And this is also like a water splat, and that's Kiwi Lane. And I just used that inside the pocket. Okay, and this next one here is just some older photos from Kauai, and it's just my boys playing. Super easy. Cut this out of a Simple Stories paper, this triangle shape here. I cut this out this summer, use that as my big title. These little embellishments here are all kind of puffy or glossy, and I use, those are from a really old sticker set that I have. And then the starfish and the little fish I just added on. And I actually, those are from the Dollar Tree, believe it or not, the little fish. And then I cut this little geotag that says summer is here out of the paper collection, like one of the cards. But really easy. I can just try to get all these older picture scrapbook that have been hanging out in my room. This is one of my favorites that I've done. I used a 6x6 paper pad, and I cut this out 2 times using a Kiwi Lane template, and then I pieced it together. And then this also is from Kiwi Lane that I cut out, and then I cut this out of my Cricut. It just says road trip. Used some wood veneers and this cork United States that I had, and then these little things I cut out of the 6x6 pad, and that's basically it. Inked everything, and super, super easy, you guys. But I really love how simple and clean, and it just kind of has like this, I don't know, this wow factor to it because it is so clean, but it has the bright colors, so I kind of like that a lot. This is another one that I really like a lot, and another older picture of one of my sons from Kauai when we were there. This is the simple stories paper. It's really old, you guys. Just used a Kiwi Lane template here, did a strip of paper, cut this out, used some stickers from the collection, and that was pretty much it. I cut this out and put it up on Pop Dots, and it was from, I think, on the paper. But yeah, I love how clean it is. And then I just did some outlining just to make it pop a little bit more, and I really, really love it. All right, and then I think the next ones I have are kind of Christmas related. So I was finishing up, I don't usually do a lot of Christmas layouts because I do a December daily, but I had these kind of like themed paper kits that I had put together here. So here's a double pager. I used Kiwi Lane templates. And then this was a die cut, it's a candle. Here's some more buttons I'm using. Some more buttons here on the candle. And I did use some gold glossy accents, and I accented everything in gold. The bell shape here is a Kiwi Lane template. These are just some cutouts that I've had, and I just added those in. And this is Simple Stories paper here, I know for sure. And then some more buttons. And just says the lights and sounds of Christmas. And just some pictures of our family around the Christmas tree this past Christmas. Really easy. And then the next one is super cute. It's my kids. Every year they do gingerbread houses or gingerbread men or anything like that. So this is another double pager here. I have a gingerbread house sticker, paper studio. And then it had these really cute button or stickers, so I used them as buttons on the gingerbread men. And these gingerbread men I cut out with a Kiwi Lane template. And behind it is kind of like packaging, like gift packaging, which kind of just gives them like a little bit of sparkle and some texture. Just thought that was kind of fun. This candy paper is super, super old. It's from like, I think, Die Cuts with a View or maybe even like a Michaels brand. I've had it for years, but it was perfect with the gumdrops and then the little lollipops that are mints. So I went ahead and then I cut out some little, made my own kind of embellishments from the paper. And then I put some more of that little kind of, I don't even know what you call that. You can't put it in your shredded gift wrap stuff. Iridescent, but yeah, that's how this one turned out. Again, here's a Kiwi Lane template back there, but it's kind of hard to see as well as just the gingerbread man. All right, I think I have one more Christmas one, and this is called Christmas Treats, and it goes like this, and Kiwi Lane templates, of course, and some old snowflake glittery stickers. This glittery word I think might be from Hobby Lobby. And then this was thickers. And I went ahead and they were white, and I used my like Copic marker, colored them red. And then I went over top of them with red glitter glue because, or stickles, because I didn't have any more enough letters in some of my alphabets to make a title. And then just Kiwi Lane, you can see it turned out really nice. Just Kiwi Lane templates here, super easy. And these are just some of the stuff that I always make for Christmas. Our homemade cinnamon rolls that I make every December for Christmas morning. And then this is a cute little, says acetate that I glued on. And then I made some like little cookies and cinnamon rolls inside there. So that one was really simple. All right, and one more left to share with you guys, and I'm done. This is a summer one from the rest of the summer pictures, but not using that Echo Park paper. This was a die cut that I had, splash. And then everything else is just old papers, and I use Kiwi Lane on here. And all these chip embellishments, the pool, the little water droplets, the ball, the seahorse, those are super old. They're from Little Yellow Bicycle, if you guys remember Little Yellow Bicycle and the little flower here. And I think I pretty much used them all up now. I had to really put a lot of adhesive under them because they're not very sticky anymore. I used a little paper clip and some ribbon. Some more Kiwi templates. I like that you can make them kind of look like waves. And then there's a little water splat there. Just some more of those. And they're very cardboardy with gloss on them. Another little paper clip. Yeah, so that is it, guys, for all of my layouts so far for the month of April. I'm really, really happy with everything that I ended up creating. I think that I've been pretty productive. I've been trying to scrapbook as much as I can during my free time, and I'm really, really trying to get in my room a whole lot more and create. I know I'm not able to do a lot of process videos and stuff for you, but I'm hoping that you guys will enjoy just watching me share my layouts with you. So until next time, I will be back to share some more with you. Thanks so much for stopping by, and I hope that this has inspired you to start making some more time for yourself and getting some scrapbooking done. Bye, guys.